Hello, Hildy. What are you doing around here?
I want an interview with Earl Williams. Mm-mm. How about a little service?
No more interviews.
Why not?
Sheriff's orders. Besides, the doctor's coming over. Can't do it.
Oh. Say, is this your money?
Well, I don't think it is.
$20?
Yeah, I guess maybe.
That's what I thought. Come on, I'm in a hurry.
Hey, Joe, open up here. Now, Hildy, don't
I won't be long. Hello, Earl.
Hello.
My name's Johnson. Mind if I talk to you for a few minutes?
No, I haven't anything else to do.
You didn't mean to kill that policeman, huh?
Why, of course not. It's against everything I've ever stood for. They know it was an accident. I'm not guilty. It's just the world.
After you lost your job, what did you do?
Oh, I used to sit around the park any place.
Well, is there anything you remember? Anything in particular?
Well, there was one fella. He talked about production for use.
Production for use?
Yes, he said everything should be made use of.
Makes quite a bit of sense, doesn't it?
Yes, I liked him. He was a good speaker.
When you found yourself with that gun in your hand and that policeman coming at you, what did you think about?
I don't know exactly.
You just thought of something?
Well,
could it have been production for use?
I don't know.
What's a gun for, Earl?
A gun?
Hmm.
Why, to shoot, of course.
Oh, maybe that's why you used it.
Maybe.
Seems reasonable.
Yes, yes, it is. You see, I've never had a gun in my hand before. And that's what a gun's for, isn't it? Maybe that's why.
Sure it is.
Yes, that's what I thought of. Production for use. Well, it's simple, isn't it?
Very simple.
There's nothing crazy about that, is there?
No, nothing at all.
You'll write about that in your paper, won't you?
You bet I will. Guess that's all.
I like talking to you. Goodbye, Miss Johnson.
Goodbye, Earl. Good luck. Oh, when you're crawling up fire escapes and getting kicked out of front doors, needing Christmas dinners and one-armed joints, don't forget your pal, Hildy Johnson.
Don't worry.
And when the road beyond unfolds and the...
Hey, look out! It's a jailbreak!
Hello, hello. Hurry up, hurry up. This is important.
Give me the desk.
Flash, Earl Williams just escaped.
Jailbreak, don't know yet.
Call your back.
Williams took a powder.
Went over the wall.
I don't know anything yet.
Call your back.
Did get away, didn't he? What do you want? What do you want?
Are you Sheriff Hartwell?
I'm here. What is it?
You're a hard man to find, Sheriff. I have a message here from the governor.
Is this it? What's from the governor?
It was a reprieve for Earl Williams.
For who?
You never arrived with this.
Yes, I did. Don't you remember?
Wait a minute.
I came through that door and I thought he was Sheriff Hartwell. I mean, you... Huh?
What's your salary?
$40.
No, don't cut me off.
How'd you like to make $350 a month? That's almost $100 a week.
No, I couldn't afford that. Who, me?
Well, who do you think?
Yes, but how do I know that...
Come in and see me in my office tomorrow. What's your name?
Pettibone. What's yours?
Pettibone?
Not really.
No. Now, all you've got to do is to lay low and keep your mouth shut.
Well, I'm tired anyhow.
Here, go to this address. Nice, homey place. They'll take good care of you. Just tell them Fred sent you.
Hello, operator. Hildy Johnson. Will you get me...
Drop that phone.
Never mind.
You're not going to tell anybody where I am. You were going to get somebody, but I don't want that. All I want is to be left alone.
I won't get anybody.
Yes, you will. You'll get them after me again. I won't let you do that.
I
guess I'm tired of all the shells.
Quiet,
will you? Waking me up in the middle of the night, talking to me about things they don't understand.
Shut up. Give me Walter Burns, quick. Tell him I need him.
Where have you got Williams?
He's in the desk. Huh? Kevin, she didn't kill herself.
How are you doing?
Let me out. I can't stand it.
Keep quiet. You're sitting pretty.
Hey, come here. See if we can lift her.
Oh, what? Nobody? Oh, never mind.
Are you going to help me?
No, I'm not.
You want me to strain my back?
Yes, I'm going to find Mrs. Baldwin.
Don't open that door.
I'm going down to the morgue and I'm going to find...
Oh, wait a minute.
What's the idea? What is this?
Hold on, boy.
Get your hands off me.
I'll give you 3 minutes to tell me where he is.
Open up this door.
Mother. Yes. Oh, Mother, I am glad to see you. Are you all right? I've been...
That's the man that did it right there.
That's a little crazy, Mother.
And I can tell you something more.
Yes?
I can tell you why they did it.
Yeah?
They had some kind of a murderer in here, and they were hiding.
Hiding it? In
here.
In here. Madam, you're a cockeyed liar, and you know it.
What was that?
He's in there.
Stand back, everybody.
He's not.
Get your guns out.
He's harmless.
Don't take any chances. Shoot right through the desk.
He can't hurt anybody. You've got his gun.
We got you covered, Williams.
Have it in a minute.
Don't try to move.
Any time now.
I'll count three.
It's hot.
One.
Ready for an emergency.
Two.
Any second now.
Three. Up with it.
I got you, Williams.
Go ahead, shoot me.
Come on, there.
Earl Williams just captured him in the press room in the criminal courts building, hiding in a desk.
Looks like about 10 years apiece for you two birds.
Does it?
Whenever you think you've got the Morning Post licked, it's time for you to get out of town.
Talking to the Morning Post.
Oh, power of the press.
Ha, 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 ha. Listen, bigger men than you have found out what the power of the press is. Presidents, king.
Here's a reprieve.
No, say, you... Say, get out of here.
Oh, you can't bribe me. They wouldn't take this.
He's insane.
What did I tell you? An unseen power.
They started right in bribing me.
Who's they?
Those, them.
That's absurd on the face of it. Walter is talking like a child.
Yeah, out of the mouths of babes.
Hi, babe.
Come along with us. We'll take you over to the warden's office and deliver this reprieve. Come along, Pete.
Vows to tell my wife.
You won't have to.
Wait till those two future jailbirds read the Morning Post tomorrow.
Tight squeeze, though.
Give me Duffy.
That's the worst jam we've been in a long time.